Venus and Gold tonight?
Yes.
Because what was yours, your reaction to see Jack being named an All-Star after you see all the work that he's put in, you know, even before training camp?
Yeah, for us, certainly expected. I mean, there's no question he's been one of the premier players in both directions, with and without the puck this season, and a leader in so many different ways, and his work ethic and his, you know, his lead on how we want to get the Sabres hockey going. There's no question if you watch him, you're being entertained every night, whether you're a coach or whether you're a spectator. So he's very deserved to be in that circle, if not near the top of that circle.
Have you decided on a lineup yet tonight?
Yes.
Well,
yeah, no, I mean, we, you know, we'll see something in the area of what you saw at the skate yesterday. So everybody that did their homework will know what that is. But it's definitely, you know, more about us confirming what we felt good about against Boston. We'll be tested. Tampa goes a little deeper in the way they can attack. Their first two lines kind of spread out the scoring versus Boston being such a top line leading team. And Tampa as a group, really, and the inclusion of their defensemen is even more dynamic than it is with Boston. So we will be tested defensively here for sure, and need to confirm the defense we've been playing of late, but need to add to the offense, and hoping the power play takes that lead, not necessarily in scoring, but in its habits and in the way it executes and how it performs. We will always feel that momentum into our 5-on-5 game. So, you know, we need that to happen tonight to finish 2019 with a game that we're really proud of. So, you know, that's what we see tonight here.
You talked Sunday about it was kind of unfair. Your PK ends up giving up 2 goals when you look at the numbers. But what made Lazar and Asplund so effective on the PK in that game in spots?
Yeah, I mean, they're just really, really proud of having that role here with us. And I think that PK is a lot about pride and the willingness to get into shot lanes and to, you know, to play within the structure. But also they showed some courage to push the PP back into its own end and take some offensive opportunity. We'd like to add that a little bit to our PK arsenal, that we're also a scoring threat. And that was an interesting sign that they gave us. And, you know, we're actually thinking about some of those opportunities that we could take. And, yeah, it's just playing within the structure that we have out on the table. And it was actually really, really disheartening that they got those goals against, because we really felt something good happening. So let's build on those good things here today against the number one power play in the National Hockey League. You know, so it's an excellent test for us on that side of the specialty teams.
Have you liked that since Dahlin's gotten back? It seems like he's getting the puck to the net more often, especially on the power play for you guys. Now that teams are focusing maybe more on Jack and Olsen, it's taking a
Yeah, I think we're all excited about what we're seeing with Dahlin and his 5-on-5 game. You know, he's so much more confident in finding his responsibility without the puck. You know, with it, he's always exciting to watch, but he's also been very responsible that way. And on the power play, he's a lot of fun to work with. He's big on the video and on the overhead camera to see what's opening up and how he can use those lanes better to create chances for us. And of course his shot, he's working on it so hard that's a weapon that we'd like to see used more often. And just bit by bit, Rasmus, because of his hard work off the ice, his hard work in practice, and his hard work in the video sessions, he's improving. You know, it's just the power play for sure is going to be the, you know, his anchor role throughout his NHL career, but it's all the other things too that are exciting us.
How much has Curtis's versatility helped him make an impression and earn opportunities here?
I mean, again, his evolution through training camp, going to Rochester, coming back has been really positive, because he's now settled in and feels comfortable and is relaxed actually in his execution. And we believe he's going to evolve into a stronger faceoff percentage centerman. He's got all the tools to do that. And then his, you know, his positional play, his acceptance of the role that he has here. I think he's understood the role he needs to take on to be a National Hockey League player. And the addition of the physicality that he can bring, you know. So there's a lot of things that we're excited about. He definitely can play up and down the lineup and help out our penalty kill. So there's a lot of things with Curtis that are good. And on top of that, the work ethic that he puts in around the game is very positive.
Every position is important, obviously. But if you were starting a team from scratch, would you start with center, goalie, defense? Where would you?
I think you know, every excellent team has two centermen of different personalities leading the way, always, and the same with defense. You need someone to quarterback your power play, but at the same time be able to shut down the best players of the other team. And then, you know, goaltending, of course, which is evolving here in a nice way. But those would be the positions I'd be starting a team in. There's a good chance he'll be in our lineup today. We're still making a final decision, planning to warm up with 13 forwards and make that final call. But there's a good chance we'll see him. It's an opportunity for us to get to know him, and to, you know, as he missed training camp, it's good to run him through all the different stages of becoming a part of our group.
Thanks, everyone.